want something. As thou gave me the name. And I will treasure it forever.
Unfortunately, even with my ability, I was unable to absorb all of Fodra. However, it did not end in failure. I was able to capture her heart, the part of her overrun by hate. The core should now return to normal, and in time regain its composure. Considering the way things end, with her.
Who?
With the heart of Fodra. Her animosity continues to swirl within me. I hope to understand her hatred, to melt it away, and eventually change it into trust. Who knows how long it may take? This could last a century or two, but we have the luxury of time.
That's so long. Does that mean that you will be alone all that time?
I no longer consider myself alone in this world. Not with a friend who can live forever.
Me?
Watch over me as time goes by, Protos Haste. Please, watch over my progress. I will start dreaming together with Fodra. In that dream, I hope that eventually we may form a kind of common understanding. Just as this man did for me. When we finally wake up, I think I would like to accompany her on a long journey. And see the world. Now the time has come. I shall return Asbel to you.
He was going to dream with Fodra.
Yeah. That's what I heard.
Asbel, are you okay?
Yeah. I think so.
Why are you crying? From this point on, you don't have to fight anymore. Everyone here understands just how you feel. Please believe me, your dream will live on. It will be treasured and passed down among their children. Come with me and we can watch over them, you and I together.
Together?
You're crying.
The little queen gave me all of her tears.
Oh,
Fodra is green once again. Let's come back to see it. Together. Again. Everyone, let's go home. To Afinia.
You want to be dropped off here?
Heck yeah! I want some time to take a look around the city.
You're going to investigate and see how the new Valkyrie system is working, is that correct?
Uh-huh, you bet it! It would be totally irresponsible not to follow up.
I know we take it for granted, but Pascal is really amazing.
Mm-hmm. That's right, and don't you forget it! Keep those compliments coming!
Aren't you forgetting something, little sister?
Huh? Maria, you came to see me! See you?
Yeah, right. I could smell you from a mile away.
How many days has it been since your last bath?
I kind of forgot.
No, I give up. I refuse to look after you anymore.
Take a stray cat off my hands?
Hey, let me go!
Sorry, but I am more of a dog person, actually.
Meow.
Better scrub her down, just like you would a stray cat.
Goodbye from me, too.
Thank you for everything, Captain Malik. You too, Pascal.
Goodbye, everyone.
Until then. Don't forget to swing by Launt. Mom would love to see you. Don't worry. Besides, I'm sure I'll be back for your wedding.
What?
Don't tell me that. You still haven't talked to the poor girl. Like you're one to talk. At least I tried to talk to her. She just didn't really get what I said. Then it's no different.
Those two are so much alike. In the strangest of ways.
How are they alike?
understand someday. Sharia.
Yes?
Your relief work has been invaluable to us. However, I wouldn't want you to lose sight of your own happiness. It would be most tragic if an angel of joy, such as yourself, decided to abandon her own contentment. And besides, your happiness is Sophie and Asbel's happiness as well.
Thank you, Richard.
I just wouldn't feel right if I moved on and left you behind.
I don't know. You kind of sound like a sore loser. Tell her how you feel. If you don't want to end up being a total loser.
Well, all right then. I think that's my cue to leave.
Bye-bye, Hubert.
Thank goodness you're safe, my lord.
I apologize for making you worry. This latest excursion reminded me all the more of how precious peace is. I want to build a future for Windor, for Athenia, and for Fodra. There is more than enough prosperity to go around now. But I still have much to learn before I make that dream a reality. When peace is restored, I'd like to see more of the world. Asbel, Sophie, when that time comes, will you accompany me on that journey?
Of course.
Sure. You know it. Whenever you're ready, we can all meet once again at Mont Hill.
Okay. I must be off. Thank you for everything.
I suppose I should get back to my relief work.
Oh, yeah, right. Good luck out there. I know I'm always really bad with words, but please, if it's okay with you, I want you to come live with me. I know you have a lot of things to do, so I won't ask you to come back immediately. I'll be the one waiting for you to come back home this time. Sophie and I will wait for as long as it takes. All right.
Asbel. Sharia, last night, I had the strangest dream. happy if that dream came true? Will it come true? Well, it just might. I would be so happy if that really came true. That's good.
I promise, I'll watch over this world forever. Once there was a young boy who discovered a lost seed. He planted it in his yard, and he took care of it every day. Over time, the lost seed grew up and blossomed into a beautiful flower. What do you think happened to the seed after that? It turned into a bright, shining star that watched over everyone. This was its way of thanking the boy who had been so very kind to it. Which star was it? Well, it's the one we all know best. Our favorite star of all.
Marcy and Enclave. I wonder if Sophie's gonna be okay after this.
Asbel.
Richard, when someone dies, that's the end of their friendship, right?
Are you thinking about Sophie?
Yeah. What happens after we pass away? We would just end up becoming some distant memory for those left behind. If everything ends up disappearing in the end, what's the point of all this? And where would that leave Sophie? She would end up being all alone, without any of us to support her.
Asma, let's not worry about such things now. That day is far in the future.
You don't know that. We can die tomorrow, or even today.
Asbel, calm yourself. Even if that happened, all we can do is value the time we have with Sophie. That way, a part of us will remain in her heart after we're gone.
Do you really think so?
Yes, I truly do. Now come on, let's go see Sophie.
Yes, I am.
You must help us. We were making explosives, but something went wrong and... Oh, it's horrible.
Of course. I'll come right away.
Sharia? Hey, the cook's asking what you want for breakfast. Sharia? It's a little early in the morning to be running off. Hey, there you are.
I'm sorry, I had to go help more of the wounded.
Oh, well, I guess that... Jeez, Sharia, you don't look well at all. Are you all right?
Oh, I'm fine, it's... I'm just a little tired, is all.
You're burning up.
I'm fine, really.
You're not fine, Sharia. You have to rest. You okay? Can I get you anything?
Just keep holding my hand.
Oh, I'm sorry.
Why are you apologizing? When we were kids, you always stayed with me when I was sick.
Yeah, because you used to cry and tell me I couldn't leave.
I did that? So why were you looking for me earlier anyway?
Oh, don't worry about it. It wasn't important.
I see. It's weird to be sick again. It's been a long time. Back then, I just wanted to be healthy so I could keep up with you.
I guess Sophie helped your wish come true, huh?
Yes, she did.
And once that happened, you raced past me and never looked back.
That's not true. I was always with you, Asbel. And now I see that you are always with me.
I suppose. You're acting kind of weird today, Sharia. This isn't like you.
Maybe it's the fever talking.
Go to sleep, okay?
I'm stronger, you know? And then we can run at the same pace. We can do anything if we stay together, Asbel. We can even bring peace to Ruthenia.
I know we can't, Sharia. Sleep well.
Thanks, Asbel.
Pascal! No, Sharia! Why do you run away as soon as you see me? Get into the baths this instant! Everyone stay on your game!
Dark in heaven's light, bear this name.
Yeah, that's it. everyone okay? How bad are your wounds?
She's warm and soft, so this is a baby.
It's okay, little one. This girl is your friend. Sagan, I want to name our new child Sophia.
Sophia. It's a good name. Let's call her that.
Sophia. It's a name born from my name.
In a sense, you're the mother of our daughter's name.
I'm a mother? Hello, Sophia. I'm Sophie.